Hey everybody, it's Nani from Printful. For the past few months, e-commerce has experienced unprecedented changes and new challenges, and so has Printful. Our incoming order volume is still growing, and we're still seeing long fulfillment times and shipping delays at Printful and industry-wide. Each week, we increase our order output thanks to the additional staff we've hired, as well as the printing tech we bought to scale up. Even with all the steps we're taking, our most popular product categories have long fulfillment estimates. So today, I got the chance to sit down with Vincent, who's our Director of Operations for our Charlotte Fulfillment Center, to answer some of the most popular questions we've received.
So our fulfillment times vary by the product type and also the facility that we're fulfilling out of. As of right now, the worst case is with direct-to-garment or apparel products, t-shirts, hoodies of that sort. We're seeing sometimes 4 to 5 weeks for those fulfillment times. That's kind of resulting in the backlog that we had at the kickoff of the COVID-19 shelter in place. Other categories like phone cases, engraving, coffee mugs, some of our wall art have caught up, so their fulfillment times are starting to return back to the average. Most of that information you can see as it changes day by day from the FAQ page that's up on the website for COVID updates. We understand sort of the struggle as our store owners see the fulfillment times growing. That can't continue to be the way that it is, and we know that it's the most important goal to return to the new normal. Our fulfillment times do vary based on the location. Obviously, the capacity of each facility is different, as well as the products that they're fulfilling. Some of our facilities are specialized. They focus on primary groups like cut and sew production for some of our all-over print or products that require a special pattern. For example, like leggings, pencil skirts, pillows, other things like that are mostly fulfilled on the West Coast versus our East Coast facilities that specialize in direct-to-garment, embroidery, and some of our non-apparel production. So right now, there's no special prioritization for any particular product. Everything is considered a priority right now with the backlog of work. Each facility does have to focus on the items that they can actually fulfill. But we do try to fulfill all of our orders in a FIFO or first in, first out system. Obviously, there are some conflicts with that when you're pairing up items that maybe have different capacities at this time. For example, a neck gaiter and maybe a cut and sew dress are not going to be able to fulfill at the exact same speed. So while the neck gaiter might be finished very quickly, that dress might take longer to fulfill. Same with our products in direct to garment, matching up with the face masks that we're fulfilling right now. You're gonna see that the delay with our apparel printing causes a delay with that face mask since they have to ship out together in the same package. Neck gaiters only take up a small percentage of our overall production. So generally we're shipping those out as single items and they're moving very quickly. But if they get paired up with something that moves more slowly, obviously that's gonna have a negative impact to the shipment as a whole. So we are attacking fulfillment times from every possible angle. Between scaling up our production team, training in a very unique way with the COVID restrictions in mind, as well as just investing in additional machinery. We've invested over $4 million in new machinery across all of our facilities worldwide. So not only the expansions that we've made at existing facilities, we've also added some new facilities this year already. The Barcelona, Spain facility is now online and really giving a hand to the Riga facility as far as catching up on their backlog of work. Our Mexico Tijuana facility has also expanded to a larger facility and will begin taking on some additional new product categories here very soon. Not to mention our Canada facility, which is in the pipeline to assist us in the US as well. On top of that, just making sure that we're making the most out of every hour in the week in all product categories, even when 24/7 isn't possible. We're working very hard to expand as much as possible on each capacity. We have had to disable some aspects of the customer experience from pushing certain products or adding new products to your storefront or limiting sample orders for the time being. But in reality, it's with the best intentions. We want to make sure that we in operations are able to focus on existing customers, existing storefronts. As soon as we're able to return to more normal fulfillment times, we're looking forward to re-enabling product push features and other features that have been temporarily disabled. So it is still possible to create manual orders or even personalize what your garment's going to look like and save that as a template for when this is re-enabled for you to actually push the products. My biggest suggestion right now is focus on the products that you know we've already caught up, at least in terms of fulfillment times. So push phone cases, push coffee mugs, push other products of which you know the fulfillment times are on par with what your customers expect. But on that same note, customer expectations, if you're not setting the expectation for your end customer, then that's what's gonna really lead to the frustration. We've appreciated the support that we've gotten from our customers and store owners who have sort of fought to defend us knowing that our fulfillment times are behind. But if your end customer doesn't know that information, it's hard for you to really manage those expectations after they've been waiting for so long for a product. Set that expectation up front and you'll have a much better experience, and I think your end customer will appreciate it knowing what they're getting into at the time of purchase. Yeah, so the word normal is a difficult one, but on the bright side, there are some product categories that have already started to return to normal. Like I mentioned with phone cases, other non-apparel products and wall art. In some cases, our Europe facilities have actually been able to catch back up more quickly, but it's still gonna be some time before we see normal fulfillment times, at least in terms of apparel. I wouldn't say that we can really give a hard ETA, which is the most unfortunate thing right now, but I think it's important to note that we're working tirelessly to try to get back to that normal. And even though we may still have restrictions, we're still going to have this COVID impact for a long time. We're gonna do whatever it takes to make sure that we're back to the pace that we used to commit to on a regular basis. And just know that that is our end all be all goal. And we will not stop scaling. We will not stop investing until we reach that point. This has been one of the more trying times at Printful, not only for myself, but for all of my team members, and that goes worldwide. I've seen some of our team members work beyond tirelessly, and they understand the gravity of the situation. In the beginning, it was more of, we thought things were gonna drop off. We thought it was gonna be a slow time, but there was a shift in the industry towards e-commerce, and we felt that full force. Now trying to struggle to grow and scale at a time when we have all these sort of requirements, it adds a lot of stress to the situation, but I've been impressed. I don't think our team's ever been put to such a test before. And honestly, I think we're by far stronger than we've ever been. Everyone got very creative, very intuitive in terms of finding a way to scale up, train this massive amount of people, and coming closer together despite having to stay socially distant.
A huge thanks to Vincent for taking the time to talk with us. I hope this gives you a better behind the scenes look at what Printful's doing. And as Vince mentioned, there's some steps you can take right now for your store. Check out our COVID-19 page regularly, explore selling products that have faster fulfillment times, promote more of these products in your store. Be proactive with your customers about delivery times as well. We have a blog article with some of the tips on how to best communicate with your customers and what steps you can take during this time. We've also prepared email and social media copy templates you can use or get inspired by when communicating with your customers. There'll be a link to them in the description below.